Many of you plan to quit ministry, to quit the church, to quit God. Pastor, I've been praying for so long. I don't see any breakthrough. I've been praying for my college education. I don't see any breakthrough. It's not worth it to serve God. And the enemy came and tempt you for you to quit. The devil is tempting you to leave the church. The devil is tempting you to leave your marriage. The devil is tempting you. And I'm telling you, the victory is yours.
God bless you. I'm Apostle Guillermo Maldonado, and I want to welcome you in this program. I'm ready to speak to you about the kingdom of God, how the kingdom of God can be demonstrated here and now. Is the kingdom of God just a theological concept, or is something that you can experience it here and now? So I want you to be ready to listen to this powerful revelation. And if you're a believer, if you really want the fire, the presence, and the power of the kingdom, I want you to listen to it very carefully. And I want you to bring heaven on earth here and now.
We are so confident that God will speak to you in a supernatural way through Apostle Maldonado's new book, The Kingdom of Power, How to Demonstrate It Here and Now, that we will give you the first chapter of the book absolutely free. Download it today at thekingdomofpower.com. Stay tuned as we continue to hear the message from the series, The Kingdom of God is Within You.
There's specific area where the Holy Spirit spoke to me, and then he said, there are many of my people, they're being tempted in this area, so they need to hear this message. I want you to take some notes. There's a spiritual conflict between two kingdoms. We are fighting against spirits that never were here on the earth before. Spirits are persons without a body. The conflict, the spiritual conflict starts with the victory of Jesus Christ on the cross. In other words, we are fighting knowing that the victory is already done. This is the beginning of the conflict. Knowing that the victory has already finished, done, completed on the cross. And with that mentality, you fight not to win. You don't fight to win. You fight to enforce the victory. Can I hear an amen? In other words, the conflict starts with the victory of Jesus Christ. Satan has been disarmed, defeated, destroyed, and dethroned. So we are fighting a battle. We are fighting a battle. We're not fighting it to win it, but we fight it because it's already won. Can I say an amen? Can I hear an amen? So we understand the victory starts with Jesus and the cross. It's finished, it's done, it's won, so we need to enforce it. Now, but this is the side of that spiritual conflict I want you to teach this morning. The Holy Spirit woke me up and they said, this is what I want you to teach. And I'm going to speak to you about, in that big picture of that spiritual conflict, I'm going to speak to you about the three legal powers given to the enemy against you. What? Pastor, but you told me you got the victory. Yeah, that's the thing. That's what I told you. Even though the enemy has been given by God three powers, legal powers, to come against the church. Why God does that? Because, my friend, even in war, there is right. He has been defeated. He has been disarmed. He has been totally destroyed. But this is not over yet. So in the meantime, God has allowed three legal power. I didn't say three legal authority. Authority and power are two different things. Authority is the legal right to act. Power is the ability to do. Number one, the devil has been given power to tempt you. To tempt you. Numero dos. Two, he has been given legal power to persecute you. And three, he has been given legal rights to accuse you. But this is the victory that Jesus. In other words, he doesn't have any legal right to come anytime and persecute you. He has to first knock the door and check if you have any door opened. Check your neighbor and tell him, don't dream and don't sleep on the pastor now. Touch your neighbor and tell him, don't sleep on the pastor now. Can I hear an amen? So this three legal power. So many of you do not have discernment. They don't understand these three legal powers. And the, if the Lord spoke to me today, it's because you need it. Hey! Three legal powers. Power to tempt, power to persecute, power to accuse. So there's three powers. And today I will speak to you on the legal power of temptation. And this is what we're going to start saying. Where is the base of every temptation? Where is the strength of every temptation? Number four, where's the power of temptation? What is the plan of the enemy, that person without body, to tempt you? And let me start writing this. What is the purpose of every temptation? The purpose of every temptation is to listen. Lead you, take you, push you into disobey God.
We will be right back with Time for Change. The Bible is full of evidence that God wants to supernaturally intervene in our lives. Listen to these powerful testimonies of everyday men and women of all ages and races and believe for your own miracle today.
Motivated by an eternal and supernatural love, God manifests himself to interrupt the darkness, revealing the light of his glory, bringing an all-inclusive movement, salvation, healing, deliverance, creative miracles, and much more.
Hi, my name is Stephen Martin. I grew up in a Rastafarian culture. I used to have long dreads all the way down my back. I used to have long nails. I used to always smoke weed. I started at the age of 5 picking up spliffs, which is joints. And that belief is clearly witchcraft. We will say Jah, which is in Psalm 68, but I would never knew who God was. I would just say Jah because it was a traditional thing. Weed was the mediator. I grew up saying God's name when I never knew who God was. I had a supernatural encounter with the power of God in my room. God has empowered me with his supernatural power to take it to this generation, to this street, as we have been commissioned from this house and our apostle Guillermo Maldonado to evangelize and set the captives free. Watch this.
I remember I went to go get drunk at a place, not expecting to encounter God, and what God did was encounter me.
But Stephen prophesied to me. He said, the Lord wants you to repent because you don't have a repentive heart. The Lord wants to come and change you. And the present fell, and I just was weeping and weeping and weeping. And I said the sinner's prayer, and ever since then, I just kept going strong because in the world, there was nothing for me. There was nothing but lust. There was no love. I'm not coming back to you.
Thank you, Jesus.
I grew up with the wrong concept of what a family was. I didn't know what love was. Like, I couldn't see like a mother hug her daughter, or I didn't even know what a father was.
Well, when I was younger, I remember just going up to my mom and being like, Mom, I want to take a bath with you. And she told me no. And I'm like, but why? I do it all the time with Dad. And then growing up, nobody explained to me what it was or nothing. So it opened the doors for many more times for it to happen, and I thought it was normal. But then when I went to sex education in school, I had my first nervous breakdown because I seen what it was, and it hurt me.
Because I was rejected so much, I looked for who I was in sex, because that was the foundation of what I was. So every relationship led to abuse. It led to being used as someone's body and not even a person.
The guys would come in my room, I would just lay there, and they would touch me, and then I would just get up and leave like nothing ever happened.
One night, disciple Jesus gave her a prophetic word about a year ago.
In the streets,
and she said she never forgot it. It haunted her until one day she came back and she looked for him. And then she went back to the world, and now she came back.
He showed me what love was, and love is more than infatuation. I never thought in my entire life that someone invisible could love me so much.
I was about 2 years old when I was brought to Sweden from Thailand. I grew up in a very different lifestyle. I grew up as a Buddhist, and my mother taught me how it was to be a Buddhist and how religion worked. But I never knew what love was. I thought that love was to seeking it for man in striptease, in prostitution.
I had everything in the world. I had money. I had apartments. I had everything I could ever wish for. But something I was missing, it was in my heart. My whole life I've been hearing how ugly I am, what a failure I am, that no one loved me because I was abused as a child. My mom was a prostitute. No one ever told me I love you, no one.
And it came to a point in my life where I didn't understand what was the meaning of life, what was the purpose of life. It was a sudden day at a coffee place, and suddenly two people came up to me and they spoke about God. And it was something that set my heart free when I heard that word, God. I didn't understand what it meant, but I felt it in my heart. And when they started to prophesy to me, to see things in my past, it was a veil was broken off out of my heart. God set my heart free from manipulation, from striptease, from prostitution. And what I can truly say who God is love. God is passion. God is everything. Wow.
Years ago, doctors diagnosed me with basically schizophrenia. They said there was no cure and that I would have to be on medication the rest of my life. But God set me free and delivered me. And it's been over 11 years that I've been off medication. And by the grace of God, now what God is doing is extraordinary. Come see some of the things in the supernatural movement.
There is a conflict between two kingdoms, between the kingdom of God and darkness. purpose. But for this purpose, the Son of God was manifested, to destroy the works of the devil.
Welcome back to Time for Change.
So what's the purpose of every temptation? The purpose of every temptation is for you to take you to disobey God. So that means that temptation, when it comes to church, every temptation, when you speak on temptation in the church, everybody takes it into the sexual part. Pastor, I'm an old man. I don't have any temptation. No, that is not temptation area where temptation comes. Every age, every level of stage of maturity has their level of temptation. Shut up, back up, put your hands together. Come on. Tell them a spiritual conflict. So every level has their own temptation. So where is the base of every temptation? What is it? Write it down, please. The base of every temptation is in 1 John chapter 2, verse 16. John chapter 2, verse 16. All that is in the world, the lust, what is the lust? Listen, lust means a perverted desire. Lust means uncontrollable desire. A perverted obsession, desire. The lust, every temptation, listen, church, is based on first, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. When the enemy wants to come and tempt you, he will check these three areas. James 1:12. Blessed is the man that endures temptation. Approve, he will receive the crown of life. Verse 13. No one say, when he's tempted, I am tempted by God. Because God doesn't tempt anybody. Why? Listen, why? Because temptation always comes to make you to disobey God. So he will not bring something to you to disobey himself. Now, there's a difference between being tempted and being tested. What's the difference? God can test your heart, but not with evil. How can you test it? God can test your heart. And for God to test your heart, you have to have two options to make a decision over it. If you don't have any option, you can't be tested. I'm going to give you an option. I'm going to give you an example. You got a job that is offering you $100,000 a year. You got a transaction that offers you $1.5 million. And by the other side, he's offering you less money. You have to have two options to be tested. If you don't have two options, there's no reward. You're not tested, because what are you going to decide on what if you only got one option? So, my friend, always before you get your Isaac, you will have your Ishmael. So you have to decide between Ishmael. I'm speaking to the young people. I'm speaking to my young daughters. There's an Ishmael behind you, after you for a long time, and you think it's God, and it's not God. Put your hands together. God is bringing you your Isaac. God is bringing you the right person. Stop dating with someone that is taking you to disobey God, taking you to disobey your parents, taking you to disobey me, taking you to disobey your father. Stop doing it and obey God. That is it, Ishmael. So where's the area of temptation? Temptation always comes to push you to disobey God. That's why God cannot be tempted. So God said he cannot be tempted. Verse 14, then how temptation comes. How's the enemy bringing you? Because it's a legal power. God cannot say to the enemy, you can't tempt him. As a matter of fact, God said, tempt him. I can tell you he's mature now. I can tell you he got my word. I can tell you he got my power. I can tell you he can overcome sin. So any area, okay, what does he say? But each one is tempted when he is drawn away from his own. His own desire and enticed. The lust of the flesh is based on the desire you have inside. In other words, no desire, no temptation. Number two, the lust of the eyes and the pride of life. One of the greatest temptations, the Lord said to me, is the temptation of quitting. Many of you plan to quit ministry, to quit the church, to quit God. Pastor, I've been praying for so long. I don't see any breakthrough. I've been praying for my college education. I don't see any breakthrough. It's not worth it to serve God. And the enemy came and tempted you for you to quit. And I tell you this morning, look out of my face. Do not quit on God. Do not quit on me. You keep fighting in the name of Jesus. You're not going to quit. Answer is on the way. Healing is on the way. Miracle is on the way. Business is on the way. Something is on the way. Somebody have to shout. Somebody have to shout. God is telling you today there's a conflict. And the enemy has come to persecute you. I've come to tempt you. But you will say today, no to the desire, no to the loss of the eye, no to the pride of life, no, no, I stand in the kingdom. Put your hand together. I said, God is talking to somebody. Pastor, I was ready to give up. I was ready to throw the towel. I was ready to, I can tell you now, I came from God. God got me up this morning and God said, tell my people, the devil is tempting you to leave the church. The devil is tempting you to leave your marriage. The devil is tempting you. And I'm telling you, the victory is yours. Okay, lift your hands and say, Father God.
Father God.
Today.
Today.
I come before your presence.
I come before your presence.
I repent.
I repent.
For every sin.
For every sin.
In my life.
In my life.
I repent.
I repent.
I recognize.
I recognize.
I have opened.
I have opened.
A door to the enemy.
A door to the enemy.
I have given the enemy.
I have given the enemy.
Legal right.
Legal right.
To tempt me.
To tempt me.
And today.
And today.
I resist temptation.
I resist temptation.
I resist the enemy.
I resist the enemy.
Father.
Father.
Forgive me. Cleanse me with your blood.
Say
it aloud. Cleanse me with your blood.
Cleanse me with your blood.
I repent.
I repent
of any sin.
Of any sin.
Any iniquity.
Any iniquity.
Transgression.
Transgression.
In my life.
In my life.
Right now.
Right now.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I close.
I close
every door.
Every door
to the enemy of my soul.
To the enemy of my soul.
And I send a notice to the devil.
And I send a notice to the devil.
I resist you.
I resist.
I resist temptation.
I resist temptation.
And right now.
And right now.
I renounce.
I renounce.
Any desire.
Any desire.
Lust of the flesh.
Lust of the flesh.
Lust of the eyes.
Lust of the eyes.
And pride of life.
And pride of life.
I repent.
I repent.
And I close the doors.
And I close the doors.
I take authority over every spirit behind that temptation, that evil desire. And when I command to three, every spirit, you come out of the people of, out of the people of God. One, two, three. Now. There you go. Go. Come out.
Do you always feel like you are in a struggle? Does it seem like something is always going wrong? That's because you really are in a battle, even if you don't realize it. In his powerful new series, The Spiritual Conflict Between Two Kingdoms, Apostle Maldonado teaches you to recognize attacks meant to destroy your life, family, health, and finances. Learn how to fight back and win permanent victory and success. You need to get this series today. Worship available now.
The kingdom of God is a reality. Discover how to enter God's kingdom and apply its power to every area of your life today. Call us now or visit us online at thekingdomofpower.com.
Time for Change with Apostle Guillermo Maldonado is a program dedicated to transforming biblical principles and bringing back God's moral values to our society. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. If you have a prayer need or interested in obtaining a copy of today's program in audio or video, please write us at 14100 Southwest 144 Avenue, Miami, Florida 33186. Call us at 305-382-3171 or visit our webpage, kingjesusministry.org. A Time for Change is produced by ERJ Media at King Jesus International Ministry. Thanks to the prayers and support of our friends in your area. Thank you for tuning in, and remember, today is a time for change.